In many cases, you want this kind of previewer on your Safari browser, your mobile app, or via a Lightning Flow or via a Lightning Action. And that's the topic of today. Lightning Actions are very cool because you can just select them from here, from this button menu, or you can see them on your mobile app. Unfortunately, you cannot configure Lightning Actions like other Lightning components via the edit page. And that's exactly the topic of today, how we go about configuring a Lightning Action or setting up a Lightning Action that you can easily configure or set up for working with these buttons here and still have it specific for what you want to do. So, first of all, you have to install the Lightning Previewer component. You can get the install package from our support department. Just mail at support@pdfbetter.com. Next up, you create a Lightning component in the developer console or any Visual Studio Code editor that you like. You just say new Lightning component. You give it a name, and that's it. I always name them with LC underscore and then PDF Butler. So then you create this Lightning component, but I already did that, and then you just can copy paste the code here. Important is that it implements the Lightning Quick Action without header. So that's a quick action that you can use from the button, and that you want to use the record ID. So that's the record ID of the record you're currently on. Next up is you just add this aura attribute. You can just copy paste that from the component over here that you see here, and you add our a reference to our component, so the component that was just installed by the package that you got from support. So we have our component here, and in this component you can actually configure your entire how you want this component to behave. So what required is the record ID. Required is the .config ID. This is the ID of my .config. You can just copy from the bar over here. Then you say, well, do I want to see a preview after the generation? Yes or no, so true or false. Yes, of course, I want to see a preview. Do I want to download the document after the generation? Yes or no. The box height, I will show you in a second or in a minute what that is for. And then maybe you want some delivery override that you want to store it as files, or maybe you don't want to store it. So you can just say, I want it as base64, which is a technical representation, and it will not be stored. There are of course other extra parameters that you can add, like all of these, which are explained in other videos, so we'll not go into detail of all of these items. Okay, so now we have this component set up, we have our own component, and you might want to create 10 or 20. It doesn't matter. These are very easy to create. You just have to always do your setup here. And then the next thing is you have to create a new action on the object that you want to work on. In this case, it's an opportunity, so I'm going to create a new action here. In this new action, I'm going to indicate it's a Lightning component, and it's going to be the Lightning component, my action converter. That's how my action was called here, my action converter, as you can see. So, okay, now I want to select the height, and I'm going to set 600 pixels for the height, for instance. That's just the height, how it will show on screen. And you can play around with data so that you... that you make sure it's the correct height. And this height actually matches the height of the box that you want to show the previewer in. So the preview will show, and the preview will be 500 height, and the height of this one will be 600. So that matches perfectly. It will fit, and there will be no strange scroll bars showing up. Okay, so I want to call it DocGen PDF Butler. Why not? And then I'm going to click the Save button. So I now have my action, but it's not on the page yet. So that's the next step. I just go to my page layout. And on my page layout, I can now select the action. This is the one I've created. And I'm just going to add it to the Salesforce Lightning Experience actions. Okay. click the Save button. My layout is now saved and it should be updated, so if I refresh this one here, I should be able to see an extra button over here, which luckily there is already. And if I click this button, it will actually run my action now, which is a lightning component specifically generated or set up for this page. As you can see that there is, I can do this. I can play around with the height of this page if I want. You saw that the download was set. So let's maybe make some changes to the config. Let's go for 550 pixels. And let's say I do not want to download it afterwards. So I just change this over here. I click the Save button. And now if I refresh my page, and I run this button again, it should actually not download it, and it should still preview. And as you can see now, it fits very nicely into this box. That's the box. That's the height of this box is the, and the width is defined by our lightning action. Then this is our previewer page that that sits in there. That is defined by the height that I've set over here. And the width is, of course, as width as wide as possible. And then, as you saw, there was no download this time, so my properties actually just worked. This is how you can easily configure a lightning action with a PDF Butler component that still shows a previewer and a download and all of the other sales PDF Butler configuration options that you might need.